How you going, George?
Good, mate.
Yourself?
How'd you go today?
I just lost in the last round to Nicole Welsh, 8-6. Wasn't probably the best for me, but taking nothing away from Nicole, she had to take 8 frames off me and got the job done, so a bit disappointing, but quality player, done it all.
Yeah,
I had the experience. So. What about yourself, mate? How'd you go?
First round, like yesterday, went down to Richard Young, 7-8.
Oh, that's a bit of a heartbreaker, that one. Yeah. 7-8, he's a quality player, though. It's a bit of a tough first round match.
Yeah, I was up 4-1, though. So, had a bit of a lead. And he came back 7-5, and I called it back to 7-all, but yeah.
Oh, good experience, mate.
Exactly.
This whole new fixture from Matt Harmon on our state calendar is a really good thing.
Yeah, I think so too.
Longer races, you get a bit more value for your money, so to speak.
Yep.
I mean, even if you were to lose a match 8-0, you're gonna learn a fair bit if you're playing a quality player, I reckon. So.
Yeah, exactly.
And even that pressure you feel at say 7-all and that sort of stuff. That's the sort of stuff you want to be trying to emulate.
Yep.
As much as possible to improve your game. So. Try and take something away from it and come back better for it.
That's it.
So,
some reason you guys need to speak up.
So, this is my first time on the mic here. So, this is ACT 8 Ball Live. That's the name of
the
group. So, you guys, there's a few of you, Long, yourself, Jow. Is that essentially
yeah,
the majority of you guys?
Mark Ferdinand did have a bit in it, but. I think he just wanted to step away from it, just concentrate on his pool.
Yeah.
So.
No, I think just wanted to say, I think what you guys are doing is a really good thing. So good on you for taking the initiative to get started in Canberra. It's sort of showing there is some comps happening around the place, and in Canberra especially, and not just within Canberra, you're going out nationwide. So obviously covered all reopen this year. And
I don't know if that'll happen again with Cue Ball TV back.
Danny Lynch is good at what he does.
Yeah, he does.
Not taking anything away from you guys, but he's the pioneer of that sort
of
that. And he's very good at what he does. So we're down to the last 8.
Last 8.
So we're actually going to be watching Mika Norton versus Mungrel. I'd say stalwarts of the ACT when it comes to the game.
Yep.
So played in everything, probably won everything at least once.
So they're just lags, and Mick won the lag.
So Mick will break off first. We're actually a race to 9 now, so we've gone up a frame since the last one. You got a tip for this one, Georgie? Can I hold you accountable?
Tip. I know Mick's very focused at the moment, so... I'll go Mick, just only because he's on my team.
Well, after making you choose, I'm actually going to sit on the fence because I've played both of these guys hundreds of times, I reckon, and it's just going to be whoever plays.
It's too close. I think it's too close.
It's going to be really interesting. So, great matchup. We've also got, just out of interest, we've got another big quarterfinal: Matty Harmon and Jack Phillips.
Can you give me a drink?
What's that?
Carlton.
So the winner of the Matty Harmon Jack Phillips match will play, I think. I think the winner of that will play the winner of Kenny and Neil Whitbread. So Neil's actually done really well to make the last 8 as well.
Yep.
He'll take Kenny on. And then we've also got Jason Tanaskovic and Nicole Welsh in the other quarter. And the winner of that will play the winner of this match we got in front of us here. So Mick has just broke and dumped the white. So first go Mungrel.
Yep. What do you like here? Reds?
So having a look, I guess maybe depending on what those two reds on the left side of the table and the lower half of the table are like, I might be leaning towards yellows just because of those two.
Yep.
All the rest of the yellows are fairly open. I think he's going to take the yellows. You've pretty much just got to make sure of one pot of this yellow on the bottom rail.
Yep.
I think the black goes just about everywhere. A little bit. Just a few roll-ins, hopefully. So this is the shot here, really. You want to probably float down on just below the black spot, being the area for a few balls. That's not a great shot.
From Mungo. Still got one in the middle, though.
I think he might. I don't know if that yellow on the rail now passes underneath it. Still might.
You can see the table from here.
Yeah. I'll have a look. It doesn't matter. He's not that. So a bit of a tentative start from Mungo. That being said, he hasn't left.
He hasn't left
too bad of a table for Mick. I'm not sure if those two reds on the left side of the table pass, if they both pop. If they do, I'd say Mick will be having a crack from Mick. A little bit higher would be nice, but he has to play one of those now. Just where he's landed, I think he has to
even block the pocket.
Play it in or over. Pocket weight, you put it in, that's fine. If not, leave it over the bucket. You're happy with that. He might. I think that's the shot to play. Yeah. In or over. In's good.
No, that's a good shot.
Yeah, same again, I think, yeah. This is probably a frame ball. In's preferred, obviously, but if not, cover the bag, but if he puts this one in, I'd have to.
Is he giving himself a good angle to come back up to the back table?
Yeah, I think you just roll this one in and you've got a natural sort of angle off this ball in the pocket. That's fine. So now you want to transition up to the most central red, I guess, of those three up the top.
Yep.
In terms of the table, you want to be pretty straight on it if you can.
Play for the middle.
Yeah, play for the center. This one to the top. Yeah, you just roll it through. That's a really good shot. You just a few roll throughs now.
Doesn't even use that yellow as well.
Yeah, he doesn't have to do anything great deal with the white. You just roll a few roll throughs here, really. And take roll in. Oh, a little far, that's all right. Roll in to the center.
If you can use the yellow, you can straight up in a little bit. So.
Yeah, he's fine for me. I'll back him in from here. Yeah, just rolled it in. You've just done your shot, played off the yellow. It's fine. And he's got a perfect little angle to screw back to. Pretty good on the black. Essentially his first visit, so looking pretty sharp at the moment.
Mungo will respond with a nasty hit.
Yeah, well, he called it. He probably won't be too happy with that visit of his. He could have done a little better, I reckon.
What's on the back of his t-shirt? Back of his shirt. Is that the Joker?
I think I've actually seen young Jack Phillips wearing a shirt similar to that, so I'm not sure where he's picked that one up from.
Yeah, okay.
Maybe from one of his master's mates around the country. Teed him up with that one, but I've definitely seen Jacko wearing a similar shirt. Pretty cool design on the back.
Yeah.
It's a Sunny Coast shirt.
Is that red going?
It's going dry. So that's one thing I've noticed on these tables. You either break well or you don't. When I say that, I mean, in my matches I've either potted almost breaks or I haven't at all.
Yep.
Like, it's just, and when I actually played Edmund in the second round, he didn't get one ball on the break. So that was a 8-6 match. So he's effectively had, you know, seven breaks and hasn't got a ball once, and that just kills you.
The table?
I'm not sure. I really don't know.
Because it happens to me too. I'll break and I'll hit him so hard and sweet and still nothing will drop.
I think it is, mate. It's just the conditions, you know. It's just a few different variables.
Well, that's what killed Mikhail, the big guns.
Yeah, right.
He's
was it the semi-final or the quarter-final against Joel Younger.
Yeah, right.
So we can get one on the break.
Right. And that's the thing, it doesn't matter how good you are, it comes down to you need a little bit of luck every now and then. So.
And if you break them up like these, then you don't
fight them. Absolutely.
You open it up.
I'm behind like nearly every frame, and good players will make you pay for that.
Yep. So, two troubled yellows around the black still.
I think he'll be... He's on yellows, is he?
Yeah, he's on yellow.
You can either play this cut to the centre, or just below the centre. No, he's not. He doesn't like that one. You might be playing a plant. That's a pretty good shot. Really good shot for me. He hasn't really got a result.
Left on the...
Smart shot.
Sort of. The cannon's almost straight in. It's the kind of shot you're kind of risking this.
I think he has to take it on just because of what he's gone for with that shot. And see what you're left with. That's a pretty good shot, from McNaughton there. Still got to make sure of it. It's not straightforward. Put this one in.
He has
missed it. Can't blame him for that. That wasn't an easy shot. So, big opportunity for Mangali. He's got to make the most of it. I can't see him going out here. He's probably going to have to pot a couple or pot one or two and try and find some cover somewhere.
Yep.
I'm guessing behind that red that's just above that yellow over the right pocket.
Yep.
Somewhere in there, I think he'll be trying to find a bit of cover. As long as that yellow is covering that middle pocket, he can't do too much down there.
Does it doesn't go.
I think he's going to be trying to nestle in behind that now, but he hasn't left himself a great shot.
But his dude only pushed the yellow down the rail a little bit.
Oh, that's a really good shot. Yeah, he's played your shot, although he's left it on. It's given Mick a chance. I mean, if it went in, he was probably fine. I didn't realise it played in that way, but... This is not an easy shot on these tables. I found these types of shots really hard on these tables. I mean, they're hard all the time, but... Again, this is one of those in or over.
Yeah,
you can't play it too hard. You just, he's pumped it. Okay. I guess he's played it that way to try and make sure he ended up on the yellow.
Yeah.
Yep. Good opportunity for Mangle here. Should be back at 1-1. Probably got to take this rail wall. So I'd come back out sort of just above where you are now. Maybe a little bit higher.
The fence on
it? You might have the right hand side running through the gap. Ooh, he's got away with it. Got a bit of a result there.
Sneaker shot, five rails,
right around. He mustn't be totaled. I think Mick can see it, so... There's Shrike here. I'm not sure where he's going here. I've got to call for some sort of shot here, George, because I have no idea what he's doing with this one. Maybe...
Going along there, come up there.
Yeah, double to the centre. That's a big pocket. I mean, there's not much else.
Unless he plays you down there, but then he leaves it wide open. Is there any safety here? I can't see any safety.
Unless he can rattle it out of the pocket, the red out of the pocket that he's sort of heading towards now. Oh, he's gone up down. Oh, great effort. Would have been a huge shot on these tables.
Yeah, even Mungle just went well.
Almost a magical shot, that one. So, these are the types of opportunities you can't afford to stuff up if you're going to sort of win these sorts of matches. These are the ones you've got to put away. So
Jack's just giving them into.
Cool. And you always want a good start. You never want to be down 2-0. Something like that always makes you a bit harder. Not to say you can't win, but you always want to have a good start in these sorts of matches. Should be fine. Probably go to the centre. The other centre. Yeah. Keep it simple.
Yeah,
that's
nice
a good shot.
I think we're going 1-1.
There it is. Mangrel levels this back to 1-1.
What's the score over here?
So, first time this style of event's been run by Activa with the whole state singles. So, straight knockout, I've heard. I know at least Victoria do something like this as well. So, first
they
time.
Recently,
I think so. I think it was Temujin Dixon that actually won it. He was down. I actually remember reading something. He was down 4-0, raced 5 and won 5-4.
Yeah, wow. Against?
Paul Clack.
Okay.
So he's I went away with the Australian juniors in 2007. And he was, Paul Clack was actually in the men's team, and I think he's had a bit of a break since then.
Okay.
But he's a really good player. Not sure if you've been able to see him, but just really solid.
Yep.
I think he'd be a good poker player, you just can't get much of a read off him. But yeah, so first time the ACT's done something like this, I think it's a good initiative. Something different. So
what happens when you have the trials, the normal trials, does the top 8 in this get into the last 32?
So I think this is just a standalone event. What happens in this event
has
no bearing on anything apart from those that make the final. So if you make the final, you're in the state team, which is a pretty big carrot to play in this sort of event, because instead of having to play potentially 2, 3, 4 weeks, I don't know exactly how many weeks it is now to qualify, that's all done in one weekend. So I know myself personally, I'm a bit disappointed for that reason, in that it was a great opportunity to qualify for the state team, which we haven't done before. But
you haven't done before?
Oh, I have, just sorry. That was probably my major disappointment of losing today. Was the, you always want to make a state team.
Yeah.
And today we've got two players in front of us that are going to be in there.
I'll get there one day.
Yeah, mate, that's all right. practice. And the trials are still there for that. I guess most people got confused as a singles event and then as the trials event. The normal trials are still there and you'd still qualify the normal way that you would every year. It's just there's 16, now a couple less spots. But I think they're good changes. And now in the 16, instead of having your top 9 as a state team, you're only going to do your top 7 because you've got 2 spots taken.
So
from this event.
You can see on the camera, I've got the light, the sun shining straight across the table.
We've got a... just a hold up, bloody sun.
So it's put the players right off, because it's right across the middle of the table.
Not ideal. someone's going to have to get up on a ladder.
Yeah.
That won't be me.
What are they going to put up there?
I think there's a couple of signs they've got around the place.
Yeah, right, okay.
It might be a matter of just moving one from
that side over.
It
does. So a bit of a pause there, folks.
Yeah. So a bit of a halting play. But yeah, just touching on what we were saying before about the trials, I think it's a good initiative.
Keeps bumping the camera.
Matt Harmon's been the driver in a lot of it, so he's done really well.
Yep.
To get this to where it is now. We've moved to pool start for this comp as well, which I think has been a really good positive change. I know it makes the viewers able to get into the match a little bit more.
Yep.
Sort of that instead of asking what the score is, they can just jump on their phone and actually have a look. I noticed in one of my matches it was a bit closer. You know, people can sort of come and have a look because they know it's 5-all or 6-all. And
Yep.
I really like it personally. I didn't use pool start before, but I think it's a really good little scoring system.
Oh, is that where the summit was coming through there?
Yeah. So we're all good now. We've got the sun sorted.
So hopefully it hasn't broken the rhythm.
My uncle's made it up and down the ladder safe and sound, so that's good. See if we can get some.
So, for all that, I forgot what colour you put on. Yellow. Yep. I think you should finish it.
Got a float past. Right, so, you're going to be trying to screw above the middle pockets now, obviously, to make sure he can finish on his last yellow. He's got good angle there. It's just pretty straightforward.
He's trying to sneak himself.
That's sort of tricky. I think he'll be fine. He's a little hampered. Obviously, you'd prefer to not be hampered, but he should be fine. Makes this missable.
How hard does he hit it?
It's a good shot. He's lost his water a little bit, but I think he should be fine.
Just screw this, make sure you don't go at all.
I think you just play natural.
Natural?
Come off the angles, yeah, that's fine. Good shot. Yeah, nice. It was sort of where those reds were, he was always alright. So I was just trying to get some updates of scores in the other matches. Thanks for the ever reliable pool stat.
I think it's great, especially now that it's going to begin on the Wednesday nights.
Yeah, on that as well. People are going. Absolutely. And obviously takes a bit of that sort of admin side away from Matty as well.
Exactly.
Gives him a bit of time. So 1-0 currently between Matt and Jack. Neil's up 1-0 over Kenny.
Yeah, right.
And the Jason Nicole's up 1-0 against Jason also.
Nicole's doing really well.
Yeah, she's my match against her. I was up 3-1 and then I was down 6-3. And to be honest, I didn't feel a great deal wrong. It wasn't the best quality match, but you know, that
she
was all from her, yeah.
She
tried to, but
yeah.
Definitely someone that definitely should never get underestimated.
Yep.
Can play as good as anyone that I've seen and knows the game as well as anyone as well,
yep.
So. I have no shame in losing to her, that's for sure.
Someone's got a bit of work here.
Yep, so have we just had a break?
Yeah, so he's on reds.
He's on reds. Something's a little bit ugly. I think he might play this most right red that he's sort of going to be behind now, this one here. Play this one into the centre and look for a bit of cover to play another ball in your next shot to cover this bottom left pocket because there's a bit of traffic down there. That's probably not great.
No good pointing at the screen,
Brent.
The viewers can't see it.
Yeah, I'm not sure what he's He just tried to get a bit of contact there to develop some of the balls.
Like straight through.
He's having a bit of strife here. Sort of losing his advantage with every ball that he pots. He'd just be trying to hang this one here. And yeah, they'll blue. So Mick could have the advantage now just because he's got control of sort of what Mungle can play based on where his yellows are, in my opinion.
Yep.
It's not really an easy run of balls for Mungle to go out, so I'll probably have to give Mick the advantage from here, but obviously still a long way to go in this frame, but at the moment it'd be Mick's advantage for sure.
He's probably just playing in the pocket, right?
He's just trying to develop a couple of dead balls, and he's played a pretty good shot there. I think he snooked him on everything. That's a really good shot from me. Mungle might be looking to sort of push this yellow straight in over there, because it's pretty ugly over there. No? Make him waste his first shot. There's only really one bad yellow, and that's the yellow under the red on the bottom left rail.
Yep.
All the rest of the yellows go somewhere, even the yellow just right of that red, up above the red,
if
that makes sense. So
he's put the yellow a bit closer to the black there.
Yeah, he's alright. If anything, gives him a bit of cover that the black doesn't go to that corner. So I think the main ball that he's going to try and have to sort out is that rail ball, and if he gets two shots, he's probably easy to go out. Again. So he needs to get his two and then have a starter ball. As long as Mungle's rolling up on something. So Mungle could play a big triple here. That's not. I think he's on it. So that dead red. This red on the left rail.
Yep.
I'm not entirely sure, but he might be able to triple it back into that corner. It might be a bit adventurous, possibly. I'm not entirely sure what he can see. He might not even be able to see that shot. He's just trying to develop it.
Locked the yellow now into the middle.
He has, so that's made it a little bit trickier, but yeah, still a long way to go.
Put the one in the middle?
Yeah, I think so.
Is that yellow? Ooh. Oh, got up on the shot there.
Swapping this, just a bit careless, just. Just got to take your time, it's easy to get complacent out there. It's been a long couple of days, getting to the business end now.
I would struggle.
Yeah, it's different to sort of playing these comps and then to sort of go deep. I mean, I can't say I've been deep in this comp, obviously, but. This style of comp, when you get to the end of a comp, it's a different type of pool because you've been playing so much. You always want to be there, but it's definitely a different experience. That's for sure.
Almost got into the last 16 at Albury.
You did well at Albury, didn't you? You're a bit of a giant. You were a giant killer, weren't you? I'd take a win over Steve Jamison any day of the year. So, and you were down 2-0, 3-0 race to 4?
It was a race of 3.
So you're down 2-0?
I think so.
And you got up. So that's a big scalp. So you're showing signs. That's good, mate.
And then, if I didn't snoop myself on the black two shots on the to get into the round of 16, it was 2-1, race of 3.
Who was that against?
What's the guy that ran it, the ball guy?
Oh, Don Colbert.
Don Colbert,
yeah.
Donnie's. Defensive.
He's a very capable player. He's played in multiple Masters Australian teams, and I think he went pretty deep in one of the world's Masters singles as well.
So he
knows what he's doing. He knocked me out of the Nationals 1 year as well. I was running pretty hot, and he slowed me down pretty quickly. So he knows exactly. There's no shame in losing to Don. So, this one's turned into a bit of a tippy-tapper sort of a battle. Mungo all of a sudden finds himself with some pretty open balls.
Yeah, I reckon Nick's going to be out here.
I think he has to just because of that shot he's played there. But if he misses, he's in a lot of trouble. So the big ball is going to be that rail ball, and I'm not entirely sure what the transition is after that. I'm not sure if he's going to try and float down on it now. So you play this ball to the top right corner. You've probably got a pretty natural angle to float down onto that rail ball. But
do you want to play? Do you want to play the one above the green?
Probably. It just depends where he lands. I think just because the angle he had, it was a natural angle to fall on that rail ball, but it's still difficult from here. You can't.
So red doesn't go into the middle. I think it does though.
This is tricky now because you can't really punch this, but you need to punch it to get some sort of position. And I don't think you can afford to roll it over the pocket. You can't afford to just hang it. That's a good shot. So
top
now,
right,
top right, and I'm pretty. Yeah, that yellow goes to the bottom right, so it's just a matter of pretty much putting this into the top right.
So just a bit of follow through to come off
and
push him forward.
I'm not sure what he's playing.
Nice. Oh,
yeah, that's a good shot.
Yeah, he's nice.
Still not straightforward. It's more of an angle than it looks on the screen.
Yeah, it is.
I'd still back him to get it. The red is really close to the yellow though, which makes it hard because it's out of your line of sight.
Line of sight, yeah. Yep.
But I still back him in, but I wouldn't be surprised if he nicks the red. Oh, he's made a double. Oh, he obviously didn't like it because of the line of sight.
Yeah.
So, big chance back to Mungo, yeah? I didn't expect the double. One's a bit far away. That makes it a little bit hard.
A bit hard when those kind of shots hit it so hard it grips to the bottom rail and stays down there.
This is obviously the good shot here. And that's a good shot. That's a great shot. A bit close, but he's fine.
Mungo being a sneaky player has got no qualms with using the jigger.
And he's you look at where that yellow is, it's essentially a free shot in a way.
Yep.
I mean, obviously you're going to back him to pot it, but
yep,
it's low risk. He can afford to have a bit of a dab. Just screw it back. Oh, he's lost his white a bit. That was I would have just had the black to the opposite bottom right corner.
Yeah.
Bottom right corner. He obviously had a bit of angle there. This isn't easy now. I mean, back him to put the pot in, he's going across it. Wow, that was just crazy. Oh, where's the ball?
Yeah, slow him down.
Yeah, I don't know. It's just that jigger shot's throwing the position a lot there, so you're going to be an interesting one. I'm not entirely sure what Mick will do. I imagine he'll be trying to leave the white on the bottom rail and just develop this yellow off the cushion and make Mungo have a go at the black. And he'd leave his yellow open. Yeah,
he's left it on.
Again, he's got a free shot to send the white. He can cannon the white into the yellow and kill the yellow off the shot.
I reckon he'll get this.
Even if he doesn't, he's not going to leave Mick with much.
I reckon he'll.
See what he hasn't left him with much, but it does mean he's pretty
he
easily snookered.
Just snookering, yeah. That's what I'd do.
he's definitely going to play the snooker. It's just you don't want to leave an easy up and down to sort of knock it in. I think regardless he's going to be going across the table to try and pot it. Mungo will be having a go to try and put this in the centre off the side rail. I'd have to think just because of where the yellow is, he can't really afford to go up the table because he can't pot it. And the black's so close to the middle pocket, you've got to have a crack, I reckon. You can't afford to. If he goes up the table, he's hitting and hoping, essentially.
Yeah, yeah.
Unless you maybe try and just kill the black one with a cushion because you're totaled. So I think the shot's across table to try and put it in the centre. Yeah, this is the shot. I mean, it's not easy, but you have to have a crack.
Well, it's easy to judge because of the...
he's missed it.
Because we're in line with each other, so it's a bit fucked.
Still a tough shot, but I think he played the right shot. Just didn't work out this time.
Screw right, screw left?
No, I think he just topped through it, maybe. Yeah. Just, I guess those sort of shots, whatever you're comfortable with.
Yeah, yeah.
But the angle was a little bit deceiving on the screen.
Yeah, it looked straight to me.
Yeah, it was. If you look at the actual, it's very deceiving on the screen compared to the table. And that's like any pool you watch.
Yeah, that's
you,
true.
You don't really have the same idea as if you were there, obviously.
Yeah.
It's a little bit nervy there. Both players settling into the match. Nick will be happy to be up 3-1 though, but both players a little bit, I guess, tentative. On the stream table, you know. Not even. It could be.
Mix used to the stream today.
So yeah, that's true.
Done it for 3 times.
I also think the first time this event, players want to do well. And that's the. I mean, not to say that affected me, but I think at this point it's definitely back in mind that you're in a position that you can do well. And being the first one, you'd love to
put
that one on your mark.
No, one red.
So I think it'd be... this is an ugly one. I'm not entirely sure. I think he'll go yellow because he's got a starter ball.
Yep.
If he goes reds, he doesn't really have much of a shot unless he's going to develop... Maybe that one on the bottom rail, yeah, so he's got a starter ball.
Just killed that one.
Yeah. So there's obviously a cluster of three balls there with the black, a yellow and a red. But there's plenty of balls around there that you could use to develop it. You can play the yellow off the left rail using the angle to go across the table. Yeah. You've got yellow on the right side of the table where you can play it to the centre and come off side rail into it.
Mm-hmm.
That's a good shot. That was probably one of his other bad yellows, apart from that little cluster there. Yeah. So he's got rid of a problem ball pretty quickly, which is a good shot. So Neil Whitbread is up 3-0 on Kenny.
He's playing well.
Yeah. Same play, Neil. Definitely can't be able to do that. Matt Harmon up 2-1 on Jack.
2-1.
Yeah, yep. Cole up 2-1 against Jason. So I'm not entirely sure what just happened there. Mungle playing a shot, but Nick's decided to just cover up and he hasn't played it well.
No, he hasn't covered it. Do you pop the one on the right and come around?
I think you do. I don't think you can risk taking the one to the centre in case you miss it. It's a bit dodgy off the cushion, so you've got to take this one and then. If you can't see that red closest to
not playing red,
you might be able to see it. You just want to get it in there
off the cushion and then.
Not great. Now Nick's got an angle if he wants to play that yellow to the centre that I talked about to develop that cluster. I'm not sure if he'll take it now. It might not be the right time.
The one here.
He's not going to take it on. Probably not the right time just because of where he's also got another yellow on the rail, but. So he's given Mungle a free shot at that bottom left pocket again, which in my opinion I would have been trying to either clean that up or cover it up. Probably didn't need to take the ball on that he took. And if you look at his white, I'm not entirely sure what Nick was going to be on next either. And Mungle's trying to disturb it. still think Mick can get his yellow in under that now and close the plant.
Yeah, I think so too. But then where does it leave it other yellow though?
I think for the time being, I don't know if you can see it though, he might not be able to see the right angle of the top yellow, but I think he has to play it anyway just because he can't afford to leave it there for the reds. The reds go, so I don't think he can leave it there. He has to play it whether he wants to or not, just to sort of disturb it and try and cover. Yeah, so he hasn't played. The shot wasn't on,
but
he had to play it, and in effect he's left it on again anyway, so... I'm not sure if he's covered the pocket in doing that as well, but just the... What you can see of that top yellow, that he actually couldn't play the shot the way he wanted to play it, but he was sort of forced into it. But now it might have made it worse, because if he buried that red into the pocket, he's in a worse position, so... Ooh. But there's still this cluster here that they want to really get into, and I now see Mick playing that yellow closest to the right pocket.
Is it touching? Because if it is, now he can play the black to free up the red.
Absolutely. I see Mick now, given what's happened in this frame, trying to cover that bottom right pocket. What, as long as that cluster is there?
Yep.
And it's hard for Mumble to go out. Starting to get a little bit ugly, I guess.
Since the first frame, it's been like this
the last few. Yeah, a lot of my mates have been like this as well. I don't know. So we've got flowing, personally. Got played four matches.
Yep.
I've had one master break.
Oh, wow. Didn't pot.
Didn't pot it.
That's right in the pocket now. That's
I don't. So what you're trying to do here is, as long as that cluster of the three balls are there and Mumble can't put his ball, Mick's going to pot the red in the pocket. So what Mumble wants to do is try and develop this ball that he's playing now, which he has, because Mick's just going to take this pocket back, I'm pretty sure. I would be, just because you then force him into either playing the ball to develop the cluster, or you don't leave him a shot on the other two reds up high on the table.
Yep.
And as long as those reds, that red's there, you can't really win this round unless you're going to put the black in there pretty quickly. So I think he's got to get rid of it now. I'm not sure what he was
doesn't want to give away too.
Yeah. I personally would have been alright with it, but he's obviously got a plan in his head of something he wants to do. But again, either player's played that cluster, and that's preventing either of them, or Mungle more so, obviously, from going out. So Mick can sort of afford to play that sort of shot.
That's a foul. Yeah, two shots for Mick, but that's not too bad.
I still think. I don't think you can get those two yellows out in one shot. I think they might be on the red. He definitely can't play it from where he's now.
No.
So I think he's gonna, in my opinion, he'll be trying to get some cover at this bottom right corner at some point, even if it's with this ball here, so I think that's what he's gonna do. But I'm not sure what the idea is of the cluster yet. Trying to put this down over the corner. You don't want it in.
Yeah, that's a good shot. That's good.
You don't want it in. If you had hung that, I reckon we would have just rolled that little bit red in the left corner and left Mungle too, but that's fine. He's still got two. You just play the same shot. The only thing is, if he plays this, the highest yellow on the table, as we can see it on the screen, it actually opens the red potentially to the right corner, but I still think it's the same sort of shot. You want to hang that. And that might be why he's playing that shot now, because he doesn't want to develop the red to the pocket. So it's a pretty pretty much the money ball is like red in the cluster because the black will go to the bottom right. So it's all about the first shot, you want to keep the two. And I'll be trying to get back down here if I can.
I thought he would have played that red to come down there again, but
I don't know what his angles are like, but he might still have a crack at playing just in this middle developing the cluster right. Because he's had enough.
I think he's doing it. That is unlucky that they'll keep the black and not to hit out of the cluster.
I think shot was on, but it was always a good chance of something like this happening. Just the angle was a little bit much. Now he played it at the tactical. So that's a good shot. But he's probably going to be behind now. Although if we can't get a starter pot here, which I don't think you can top one of those two in the bottom left.
It's a bit hard to tell what this guy's going to do.
Absolutely, mate. That's a tough game. It's just one of those things, you know. There's probably a way you should do it, but everyone has their own way of doing things. And
yeah, that's right.
There's nothing wrong with that. At the end of the day, as long as you've got black, that's all that matters. But yeah, you're never going to call every shot. It just depends on who's playing and what their preferences are. And that's probably something I'd try to tell anyone that's sort of new to the game or whatever. There's always probably a right way to go about things, but what's more important is that you commit to whatever you're trying to do for whatever shot and don't have two minds about what you're trying to do. If you're going to get down on a shot, commit to the shot, whatever you're trying to do, just put that in your mind. Commit to it, regardless of what anyone might say about the shot. I think when you're playing a shot, you probably don't think it's the wrong shot. But yeah, it's really important that you back yourself and commit to whatever you're trying to do.
I don't think it's total.
It's pretty, it's a little ugly now. I think if you can just kiss it and you run your white back up the table, you'll be fine. And he might even catch the red into the black on the lower side. There you go, that's a really good shot.
Good shot. I think Mugler needs this for
him. Yeah, absolutely. 4-1, big difference of 3-2, obviously.
Yep.
And just the way it'll rattle the confidence of the players as well.
That's fine, I think.
Should be all she wrote, yeah.
Straight just come back.
Yeah, you can either go underneath it.
The black there.
I think you just screw out without. I'm not sure, you might want to use the side rail. Again, this is a personal preference. If you can just not bump that red in, he'd probably come off the right rail with the side, but he might screw it straight back. No, he's going the other way.
Yep.
And wire at me again.
There's multiple ways he could have done it.
Yeah, absolutely. It's fine.
So, Mungle takes fifth frame. Three, two, one.
Trying to get on those yellows as quick as possible. You'd probably want to take that one on the left side to the left middle, but at this point you wouldn't guarantee you're on the yellows, so I wouldn't blame him if he just took that, the one on the right side. That's a bit easier just to guarantee you're on them. But this is the right shot to play, this one here that he's looking at. Yeah, so he's gone the right way there. Yeah, that's a shot. So I think, depending on how he can get on that top left yellow on the right side.
Do you play it next in after the middle?
Well, he's looking at this playing it for you, possibly. I'm pretty sure the yellow above those two reds at the bottom of the table goes fine.
I think he's thinking three shots ahead.
Positional shots.
He doesn't want to take that one just yet.
I think you can play the top one of those three that he's looking at now to the centre. Might develop it. No, he's going to go for this one to the bottom left.
Oh, where's the wobble going?
They got lost there.
Did he even try to kill him one of those balls?
I think he would have. And he's just found a gap, which is a bit rough, but I think the other shot he could have played is the one on the top of those three in the centre and got a nice cannon as well, but it's all done now, so still a lot of work for Mano to do from here. I can't see him going out from here. He's just got too many dead balls.
Yeah, surprised me though, so you never know.
Yeah, well that's true. It's a funny game this one. I just think you can't really pot either of those two reds at the top anyway. No, like they're just the two ugly unless you can disturb them. The rail wall, the bottom right rail is a bit hard. It's just got plenty to do. Although it's really, you roll that rail wall in and you're on the lower of those two reds to the left. Oh, he's trying to go. Yeah, he couldn't.
Now he's put another heavy tap down here.
This would be a snooker shot.
I wouldn't have thought it too much, he would have done it straight away.
Yeah, so there it is, pretty quickly. And now the proposition of two shots is a lot different with the way these balls sit.
Did you want to go and have, did you want one?
Is that alright?
Yeah, mate, go for it.
Alright, I might hand over to Furlong just for a quick mate, I'll have a break.
No worries, mate. I might have to leave in the next 10 minutes, so it's been good.
Yeah, thanks.
Thanks for the opportunity, and
thank you.
Keep up the good work. I'll see you around the place. Oh, and Mick's just missed it there, so he's given Mungrel two.
Sit there long.
First shot's an important one.
Are you off the saw, Brent? Are you?
What's that,
are you off the saw? Are you?
No, in probably about 5 or 10 minutes. I'm just waiting on a call.
Okay.
About to be summoned.
Oh well, it's be good to have you anyway on the commentary.
I'm going to be off to watch Grundle Road go around, so.
Right.
Shout out to Josh King. And Barry King as well, who's a bit ill at the moment. Get well, Bazza. Keep fine, brother. And be out to watch the Grundle go around 4:30. So, I didn't see. Did Mungrel pop that?
Yes, he did. Those red balls up there in the corner look like a mini snooker pattern.
Players are having a lot of trouble on these tables. So simple things like that.
Looks like a lot of players are missing shots due to tiredness as well.
Be trying to roll through for this one just by the black spot if he could. No.
Oh.
It was and just popped the yellow.
Both players don't look as clinical as when they first started the match.
And I guess it deeper you go, I guess, like I said, the jaws, it can start to creep in the back of your mind, how far you are and the what ifs of if I win this match, what happens next?
Mm-hmm.
And that starts to bring a few twitches and uncharacteristic mistakes you probably wouldn't see from guys.
The balls are pretty much all open. If Mick can pot this one and potentially run, oh my goodness me, that's two close jaws that you wouldn't expect from a player like Mick.
Red of those four there, I think he might. Nah, the cut was too fine. Yeah, so, again, Micah would have to be thinking of the out here. I'd be looking at that one over the right center just because you could miss this shot and leave anything. I don't think you have to play that near. That's
a great shot.
Huge shot. You got to risk it for the biscuit, and they say long.
But also that was the percentage shot, because even if he missed it, he would have left it covering the pocket.
I just thought he could have still played the one over the right centre and played a similar shot and been a bit closer and potentially play it for the out, but it doesn't matter now. He's out.
Yeah. Looks like Jack's just tied and scored to 3-2 on the other table.
3-2 Jack's way or Matt's way?
Matt's way.
So Neil up 3-1 over Kenny, and Nicole and Tanaz 2-0.
Yeah, Nick should be able to get this easy. Oh. Commentator's curse. Just trying to avoid the in off, so.
So, this is a huge chance for Mungo now. He's got to clear these balls up.
Yeah.
Level it back to 3-all. Momentum will be with him.
Well, it depends on how Mungo tackles these packets of balls, because the plant. Upon plant.
Plant. No. Layering up. It's still not a gimme from here. You still got a little bit of work to do. You got to get your white ball good here.
You might even be thinking snookering. Yep.
He may snookering. He may also play it in a way to develop the reds. So you play the one over the pocket and play it with a bit of firmness.
Ooh.
Play your shot now.
Yeah, so it'd be what I call a flick snooker.
Yeah, that's a pretty good snooker too, I think.
Although Mick can escape it by going up the one rail.
Yeah, I don't know, I don't think it's... I mean, the up and down's there. He definitely can't come off a side rail and kick into it, because he can't swerve, he has to go up and down. It's actually not too bad of a shot.
Unless he placed the Anthony cheer shot early on, which is basically go for the jaw to count it up.
Just don't like going off here, and you're pretty happy with wherever it is. Oh, he's missed it.
No, missed it by an inch.
Huge.
With two shots in hand, Mungo should go 3-3.
Alright. Well, that might be my cue to exit.
Thanks anyway, mate.
It's been fun.
Thank you.
I can stay for a bit longer, boys. But
that's alright.
Cheers for having me, and yeah, keep up the good work. Good luck for the rest of the comp.
Yeah, thank you.
I'll be watching it from somewhere, that's for sure. Thanks, boys.
Thanks, mate.
Enjoy. Good stuff. Do you want to be here?
Yeah, yeah, fine. Fine, thanks, mate. Alrighty, 3-3, and has Mick gone for his bathroom break at 6, as per normal. As he usually does, I guess.
Oh, it's good to just get away from the table, go to the bathroom, clear your head, think about that last frame, if you made mistakes, whatnot.
Yeah, certainly drawed a lot of shots I expected him to get in that last game, but pressure, it's the last state, it's playing a quality opponent. So let's do a score check around the arena. So Matt Harmon's currently 3-2 up against Jack Phillips. Neil Whitbread is 3-2 up against Kenny Nicol. Very strategic game happening over there. Nicole Welsh is also 3-2 up against Jason Tanaskovic. And best of 9, so long way to go. No play with a real advantage at this stage. It's going to go neck and neck, you'd expect. I still sold my earlier prediction that either Jack Phillips, Matt Harmon, Jason Tanaskovic, or Mick Norden. Alright, so we just asked around to see who else wants to provide a bit of commentating and comic relief. Several probably declined for the time being, so you're stuck with me for the next 30 odd minutes or so. Okay. Yeah. So, from this position, Mix on red, so should be able to pot out.
He's still got that troubled ball next to the one that's closest to the white at the moment. I think it's very tough to judge the angle here, but I think he's got the angle to come back just past the yellow.
Yeah, he's aiming for the middle pocket.
In the middle pocket. Yeah.
So I think he's probably going to go middle pocket, bottom left pocket, and probably take the black to the centre. Yes, having careful think, because obviously he missed a couple of fine cuts in the middle of the last frame.
That's a nice shot. It's got a tough one, this red one, though.
It is. Is he looking to reverse cut this?
That's a lot of traffic for the white to get in for the black. Yeah, he actually got onto the black because of kissing the yellow, but I think if he had a shoe potted, that would have widened the angle a little bit more on the white. Probably would have gone behind that yellow.
Mungrel's got a bit of work to do, but there's a lot of balls, so he'll probably just go for a snooker here.
He hasn't got it. I don't think he's got it.
Yeah, he's left Mick a fine cut to the top left hand pocket. It's a gettable shot, but it's what happens to a white after his whole position on the black. It's probably a very difficult position to leave the cue ball good on the black.
That is a nice pot. That. Now, though,
it's a really nice
black
pot.
Does the black go?
No, not
not from looking at the table, but you'll have to try some miraculous ball shifting shots, several cannons off the yellow to get something.
A long special?
Yeah, a long special. just hit as hard as you can, and hope it ricochets off the right balls and go in.
I don't think it goes past those yellows. So it could be looking at possibly just covering it up so it goes.
Well, I almost went in off of that shot. Now it's okay with that table position, but you expect Mungo to
play
some snookers.
Yeah, play safe here. I don't think he has, because he's just left that black on. Oh, no.
A double back up the opposite pocket.
I could just be playing it slow and leave the white ball near the bottom pocket. Down the bottom right, yeah, that's it.
Well, that's the percentage shot, yeah.
So again, I think Mungo will be looking for two shots here. I think it should just be hit this yellow, come off the bottom rail, then up. Didn't get that as what he wanted, so I think he's left this cut on now for Mick.
It's a very fine cut for Mick. It's makeable, but you've got to watch for the white going in off to one of the.
No, that's not about the bottom rail. Yeah.
Four through to Mick.
Mungo's break.
Should be Mungo's break.
Yeah, it is. Yep. So we've had some other, well, a few people turn up to watch their horse win, so to speak. Nice break by Mungo. Potted a red, though I'm liking yellows.
I'd say yellows look good.
I'm taking yellows. He hasn't even stopped to think straight away. He's called yellows. And
if Mungo's in form, he should be able to get this clearance.
He's walking around very confident right now.
So George, apparently Danny Marlowe reckons he can't hear your commentary. Have to balance talking loud and being so close to the table so we don't distract the players. So
okay, I've got the mic near my mouth now, so a bit closer. So hopefully you can hear me better now. Yeah, it was Brent, Danny, who you could hear before. So
yeah, now I can hear. I've got the headphones in, so I'm actually listening to the delayed commentary as well as speaking live.
Yeah.
That's a bit of a catch 22.
So Mungo's just trying to navigate it around at the moment. Just trying to see his best. Be able to get onto this yellow to get onto the other one.
He might actually pot it and nudge it up. If he's going to play that shot.
It's all about positioning him now to get this, to get him to pot the next one, to get position on the other one. So.
go with a lot of top spin, or are you going to go off the cushion, or are you going to go reverse?
I think you'd be coming back with a top to with some side. If you can get between the black and the red, I think that's what we're looking at. Or he's going around, which he might go in off. When he hasn't, he's been lucky there.
So that round on the course was because Matt Harmon just put out a clean out on Jack Phillips. So take, I think, a 4-2 lead over there.
So Mungle then was very fortunate for the right one not to go in off. It's worked out for him because now he's perfect on the black to come around for probably the black in the right middle.
Yep, top left.
Middle left to me.
Oh, did he go middle left? I thought top.
Nah. Middle left, then right left, right right middle. So I think it's going to go for all. Ow, boy.
Ow. I think that's snicked off the red.
Yeah, it did. I'm not too sure if that went, but he will not be happy with that now. He's given Mick the opportunity now. He's...
So Mick's thinking hard about whether he takes all these balls or he goes for a snooker. Could promote some balls playing this, I know, then go for it.
I think you have to go for it. If you can lay a good snooker, then why not?
Mm. Well, Danny's just said, we're tuning in and I hang on to your every word. So I think not, Danny. I think sometimes... the calls and shots that George and Meyer calling is probably the way not to play pool.
Times.
I think it's your angles that kill you. I don't think you see the angles right, long cuts.
Yeah, well, yesterday I was playing Jason Tomaskiewicz and I missed several fine cuts, and one of them by a clear white ball, so
not definitely not seeing the angle well
on the table these days.
Yeah, probably going to play this one to play the one down to... Where is the black? I can't see. So... I thought he would have played for the bottom right here.
Yeah, so did I. He kind of leaves himself in no man's land at the moment.
Yeah, so... From that position, I'm not sure... Did he play it on the top right? Is that what he's after? Yeah, I think so. Yep.
Bit of an awkward shot here.
He's got a bit of an angle, but I think you just soft stun it. Yeah, you had too much of an angle on that red. It was coming too close to the black.
So right, because there's still an awkward shot in the black here. Sorry, because I'm clearly more lower skilled now. I'd play this straight on to go off four rails back to the top pocket where it's at.
Yeah, I think he has to just play the black. Don't make it easy for Mick. Didn't really have any other shot, and he's lucky not to go in off then. So he'll just screw this up the table. Now I struggle on these shots. Full confident, put everything into the shot. He's drawn it.
So
he's conceded the frame.
The frame, I mean, not the match. Yeah, those shots are always tricky. Like I draw those shots as well. It's
hard to pick the right pace sometimes and to pick the open side on the pocket. I think I saw Edmund Chen last night have a similar shot where Jordan and end up going down to Brent Hampton.
So for all. Good break there, sunk a yellow. I probably would stay with yellows.
Yeah, yellows definitely look more open and it's an easier start on yellows. There's two reds on the rail, so I would touch red if unless I really wanted to.
Because you're speaking straight into it.
Oh, no.
Before when you were holding like that, yeah. So I just got Glenn O'Connell's message saying Long is 10 times louder than myself. Probably because he's holding the mic up too, it's like he's going to eat it. So he's no longer putting it through his mouth.
Oh, and also I do karaoke a lot, so I think you do have the louder voice than George.
So for all the folks listening and watching at home, obviously this is the quarterfinals.
Drink.
You want
one?
Yeah, so if you're watching at home, obviously this is the quarterfinals at the moment. For the AC Opens Knockout Championship. If you'd like to come down and commentate for the semis or finals, feel free to come down and do that, because George and I have asked several players at the venue and no one's put their hands up yet, so you either get stuck with me and George or two elite players will come down and do it, I guess. So back to the match. I think Mung was on reds by memory. So he's going to play the three ball plant to the middle and well done. So looking intently at what he does with a red. That's stuck in the middle near yellow. It's probably going to go on the inside of it. Ah, nice shot. Rolled in. So he'll probably take this one to the top right hand rail with a lot of backspin to try and promote the ball out. Ah, it's missed it. Well, Danny, if you feel up to it, come down and come back down to the venue and start commentating for the semis. I think we only started asking before the start of the last eight.
Actually, that's not true. We actually asked all day. It was the last 16. I think a lot of players were still playing. Brent had a stint, but he's gone off, I think, to watch horses or something. Okay, so Nick's probably going to play this one to the top right hand pocket, go to the middle and lay the ball up on the same pocket with which he's potting now. So unless he's able to promote that ball out, he's going to get a clear shot on that one that's stuck or near the reds. Okay, so he did get a bit of a promotion. So it all depends on whether he takes the left middle pocket or he goes for the double to the left middle pocket. Oh, let's go for the left middle pocket, unlucky Jordan. All the balls are out now, so if Mungo wants to have a crack, he certainly can't get it. The two balls blocking the bottom left hand rail kind of gives him a bit of safety to play the red on the rail. Back after doing a drink run for Mick Norman, among us on the reds. One of this. So if I could attack the one in the corner pocket, but I'd probably suggest taking it before he cuts the edge first.
So what's Mungrel on?
Reds.
Reds, okay. So he's going for the reverse double, he's overcut it. He's left a that yellow, it passes the bottom left red. So I'm going to say 5-4 to Mick. Don't seem it's. It'll come to the end of this shot. I think even if you come off the cushion, it's going to go in. Just needs to. Yep.
Yeah,
nice shot. So, looks like Mick's going to take the lead again. And he has.
Alright, so just a quick check around the arena once again. Matt Harmon up 4-3 against Jack Phillips. Neil Whitbread and Kenny Nichol 3-4. Tanaskovic up 5-3 against Nicole Welsh.
So the original schedule had the semi-finals played at 4 p.m, George. I don't think it'll be a 4 p.m. semi-final start.
No, not at all. We're still in the quarterfinals, so we've still got the semi-final, which is it a race to 10? Or still race to 9? So, just notice Jack's shot then, he's stunned it. Alright.
What a
shot
by Jack Phillips
on
the other table.
Wow. Sorry guys, I was actually just watching Jack Phillips' game and he just got this unbelievable black in and almost followed, almost the light almost went in as well. So good matches having all around. Very close, no one wants to give anything away.
easily.
I think that's a great shot there by Mick. I think he probably tried to pot it, but it has worked out great for him.
Well, it's definitely controlling the table now with that shot.
You can tell we're almost approaching an hour and a half in this match. And we're only 5-4. And the last 32 match was over in an hour and 20 minutes. So I think the players are taking longer than the 40 seconds allowed to them in some shots.
It's not only that, it's been a very tactical frame.
That too, yes.
People who, like, there hasn't been a clear out in many of the games, so people are just trying to grind out and taking every opportunity to try and win the game. It's to be expected because there's a lot on the line.
So, is that red down the bottom right as we're looking at the table? I think it does go off the cushion and in the yellow, so that was, it's really his only problem ball, and the other one that's closest to that right hand side. But if you can get good position and get into the middle, black pockets in both middle and right, that is a really fine cut. And
so it looks like it's going to be another long tactical match with each corner taken up. And both players having problematic balls to promote into better positions. Also, Mungo's just dynamited the red out of the pocket of that shot, but Mick has the opportunity to lay the red closest to him back in, or if he choose to try a run out here.
We're actually just contemplating putting the other scores on the screen, so all our viewers can actually see the results in the other one, but it'd be hard to keep track of all of them at the same time. Mix. He has got it. I think he's still good. No, he's still good.
Has he got enough angle to work the white?
No, he needs. Unfortunately, he needs to hit it with speed. And they actually at the start of the day, they were testing the speed of how you can hit these middle pockets. And actually took the tabletop off one of the tables and swapped it with this one here because they knew the final was going to get played. They were just rattling, so you can hit these in the middle with speed, provided you get in the right spot like that. So, and his queuing hand needs to be a little bit back now, but I think he's still good. I think he'll get around that yellow with the black in the middle.
Yeah,
that's a nice shot. Very nice shot. So, I think Mick's going up 6-4. Definitely putting the pressure on Mungo now.
Alright, so we've got a couple of the ladies that's going to test the ACT knockout top next week. And it's all going to happen on the one day. What's the chances of that whole event finishing on the one day, you reckon, George?
What's that, sorry?
The women's event in one day.
I'd probably finish in one day. I don't think you're going to have 96 people. Honestly, I don't think there is 96 women in the ACT Association. And there should be. There should be, you know, but...
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't... Yeah.
I guess they'll probably only get like 20 runners, 20 to 24 runners, so yeah, it should be
I'm not sure how many women are in Activa or joining. I guess it all depends on the numbers. But, you know, like the open singles will always have more players because it's open to male and female players. So.
Well, cracking break from Mick gets dry and it's left the pattern, which is not conducive to a pot out, so it looks like another strategic frame coming up.
Yeah, I think maybe we'll take Reds, which he is. I think, you know, if he's not going to pot out, he just wants to control that bottom rail. So unless he kept those two on the right hand side cannon, in which case he will give this a good go and try to pot out here.
Yeah, we'll have to play the plant, you know.
But actually, no, sorry, the red on the top right, that's. I think he just wants to control the pocket. I think if he pots out from here, that'd be great, but I think he just wants to control it. And, ooh, that almost dropped. That almost dropped.
So that's tagging a corner of the table. So that improves your chances of winning by 25% if you've got a pocket tag.
So I think still has one in the middle, but now that ball is
he's just killed that yellow on the rail and
he has. Can you hold this? Just trying to see. That is a good shot going off that red and clearing that up. And Wendy still has a shot. Mark Fernandes is going to join us in commentary shortly. His voice isn't fit for public.
Public consumption.
So I'm sure we'll have some of the players that lose in the quarterfinals join us. I think.
Well, we know JT and Kenny are keen if they get knocked out to commentate.
Of course, but I think JT's currently up. I think Kenny's up as well at the moment. But not by much, it's a long way to go.
Kenny's been spending a lot of time shaking his head on the other table, obviously not appreciating the long tactical frames. But he's getting results there.
So for our viewers, thanks for joining in, but if you are close by, why don't you join us down at the German Club? It's going to be a cracking final. The final should have started in an hour and 10 minutes, but that's definitely not going to happen at 6 o'clock now. That is a nice pot by Mick.
You've even got a balcony to view the matches from.
You do, actually, yeah. Yep.
The windows from above.
Right behind us. So they've removed the windows between the downstairs and upstairs of the pool area.
There is a small crowd of people
here watching.
So Mick's got a very small area he needs to get onto to pop that last yellow if he's going for the out. He's gone for it now, and he has got it perfect. That is a beautiful shot. That is inch perfect.
Could potentially be in the frame window.
Yeah, that's an unbelievable shot. That's a lot of control there to get the wobble exactly where he needed it. Now he just needs to screw back. That's it. Seven four, massive difference. Just 6-5.
Beautiful, beautiful position.
So I was actually speaking to Mick before this match. He was very determined and very focused to win here.
Ooh,
no, he's not happy with that. He didn't come through the. Either hit too hard, and he really hasn't left anything on. The black ball does go to the left hand side. It's got like a 2-ball gap. It doesn't look like it on the screen, but it's got a 2-ball gap, so it can go straight in. I think that's the shot. Just needs to be mindful of where, he's going for the cut. He's going for the cut.
Oh,
nice shot.
Goodness me, what a shot. No round of applause there for that shot.
So.
I was going to say something, I lost my chain of thought now. Anyway, back to the match.
Kyle, I know you had a question there, but I'll just answer. So after I have all the, once we've completed all the matches, I'll be downloading them and uploading them onto the ACT8 Live YouTube channel. So you'll be able to watch them all there. Depending what time this finishes tonight, I won't be able to do it until tomorrow night. Due to me having to go to work at 7 a.m. tomorrow morning. So if I can get out of here by 10 o'clock, I can spend an hour getting it done. Otherwise, tomorrow night, you'll have all of them. But you can go to the live stream link that you have for this and watch them that way as well if you need to watch them tonight. So I believe Matt's game earlier is already on there, so you should be able to watch it. If you go to the link, and it has all the live stream videos that we have in the last month, so yep, be able to watch it now. All right, back to the game. So Mick's on yellows, and he's almost potted there in the middle.
So next weekend, unfortunately, George is working, so we won't be able to stream the ACT Women's Championship. But I have organised, or I will be organising, Mark Ferdinand to come down and take a few photos. So any ladies listening out there, I guess look your best, because there will be photos and so forth taken and put on our website. There's an advance warning there.
Oh, I forgot to mention on your magazine, you didn't mention my name. Part of this, part of Matt Harmon's group. You forgot my name.
Did I?
Yeah.
I read it yesterday, and I'm like, in Matt Harmon's group had this person, this person, this person, and I wasn't in it. But that's all right. I didn't go too well that well anyway. So Mungle just playing safe here, and he hasn't blocked that pocket. But still has that, Mick still has that yellow on the right hand side. Whether he has the angle here to follow through with pace to knock it out. Nope, and he's missed that, he's drawn it. What would you do here, Mark?
So there hasn't been like a master break in this match, I don't think. So the game has really come down to who's been the more tactical player. And I think Mick's winning out at this stage. So and the score really shows that.
So Mungo really needs to play. He needs to play a bit of a tactical brain. 7-4.
Yeah, I think most of these, so I think that's a good shot. He's broken it up. One of the yellows is still near the red, but it is potable down the bottom left. Yeah.
Yeah, it's a good cover shot on Mungo, although...
So the yellow can't be potted in any pocket except for the top left as we're looking at the table.
I think Nick's going to run this one down to the left bottom pocket.
Just killed one of Mangle's shots. That's a really good shot. But now he's actually left that long red. Actually didn't clip the yellow that he wanted to, or it did clip it, not enough.
Well, the yellow's now all over for Mick.
Yeah, now.
Simple to work the white around the table. Hardest ball to get on is the yellow near the black.
Yeah, just needs to be on the bottom left-hand side of the screen on the table and should have it. He's not happy with that. That's a poor shot by his standards.
Yellow,
so Mick just said that it actually rolled on him. So there is a roll on the table, obviously.
Here, Mung was definitely favourite to take this frame. It's popped long to the bottom pocket.
Yeah, the
middle.
The black, I'm not sure if the, does the black go in the middle? Does the black go in the middle? No, okay. So. Does go in?
Going off the top yellow.
Okay. So Mark was saying that black actually goes in off that yellow closest to the pocket on the left hand side in the middle. So looks like that's what Mungle's playing. Or is it that fine that he actually could get it in? He did pot. So Mungrel gets one back.
So did just the biggest green really.
So this match has almost gone on for 2 hours, 15 minutes, and then this match would be 2 hours. So looking at this table layout, once again, it's another layout that's going to take a lot of work to develop force. No obvious hot out. I think Mungo just left a difficult ball with the red and yellows together. So either looking at the top pocket, or we might just promote this softly off the cushion. But once again, I think we're in for another tactical frame, and whoever holds Nerves is going to win this match more than likely. No worries. So Mungo was probably going to look to just hit this with dead weight and sit over the pocket or pot it, doesn't matter, either way it's advantageous. This one here will definitely push up to cover the pocket, control that corner. Good starting pot by Mick. Getting the red out from an easily pottable position to a bit more problematic. It's kind of looking hard at the yellow stuck against the cushion and what shot he goes to pretty much promote that ball. So here I think he's going to take the most right yellow and either pot it or sit it over the pot to take back control. No, he's chosen to pot. Nick's gone in off, trying to fine cut the yellow back to that bottom pocket to take control of it. So two shots for Mungo. It's probably 60% chance to go out here.
It's just that balls are in a slightly awkward position. Last night I chopped up the potting out like this. Yep.
Mungo has just played defensive, so
buys himself another shot. Buys McDuffie looking at the two balls stuck on the top end of the table and seeing how I can pot and develop those, because you can always run the yellow and the rail underneath the red at a later stage. Those two yellows are now open, although Mungle does now have his two reds open. It just depends on that configuration of two yellows, two reds, so that bottom right hand pocket, what happens there, and how to get position on it. So it's basically top pocket, but I'd go back, skin to the middle pocket. Yeah. Slightly look where he wanted the cue ball, so nice thing to have. This one, instead of this pot of ball, really losing rather awkward position. The room's suddenly gone silent, so I'm going to have to whisper because it's quite near the table. So is this left the yellow covering the black? That presents a problem later on, I guess, depending on how he goes with getting position using his other yellow ball that's closest in the middle. Could potentially get a good angle on the moon. Mungle's left into the cue ball in a position where Mick can actually pot to centre and then run off the cushion and pretty much promote the yellow out. It's gone hush, so... So that black stake to yellow still presents a problem. So both players need to promote that the black out if they're two in the game. Well, for Mick, he needs to promote the red. Needs to promote the yellow out from the black. For Mungo, he just needs to get the black out. We'll probably play the white middle first and use the left middle to do that shot. That turns the black blues. Oh, unlucky there. He's come over the black, but missed the pot. Now all Mick needs to do is fine cut the yellow to the middle, white off the rail, and get position on the yellow down the left hand pocket, and then the black goes all the table except the bottom right.
Oh,
Okay, you can play the cut. So you're looking at some cover. You're pulling the cut. Nice. Elected to play a nice safe shot. So basically blocked among them path to the red down the bottom left pocket to come back up. Top, so I think Money will probably lay the ball for a sneaker. Nice.
So.
I don't usually see those shots, as most people know. I don't play a sneaking game, but I guess next season down to second division, I'll have to relearn how to play sneakers. Oh, Mick's gone and potted black, unlucky. Just slide across the table up there and score 7-6. Let's see what else is happening around the arena. Jack Phillips has fought back and leads Matt Harmon 6-5. Kenny Nichols actually on the hill against Neil Whitbread 8-3. And Jason Tanaskovic is 7-4 up against Nicole.
And 7-6 at this match, of course. So fair break, boys potted, and reds look good, but Mungrel doesn't look like he's got an easy start. It might actually be touching.
Played a safety, good safety at that. Mix on yellows, but there's nothing potable off on the first shot. Last night I actually had a frame fade against Jason Tanask, which in one of the matches I forgot to call a total snooker. And played a wonderful shot to get out of the snooker, but then because I forgot to call a total snooker, ended up being a foul. Two visits and giving him an easy frame, which got him to, I think it was a 3-0 start, and from there he was flying. If you saw the screen move, that was just a youngster, Harmon, bumping the camera. That's all good now. It's back in position, didn't move that much, so it wasn't an earthquake. But so Mix has covered that bottom left-hand pocket, so now it makes it another tactical affair. So Mungrel's attempted to reverse double, take control of the other corner, which he's done, but he's, I guess, left the gap for Boris to come underneath. Mick might just have to play a smash and bash shot here to clear the three yellows that's still in line and just hope for a result at this stage. We can just play a gentle snick on the yellow that's on the rail and leave Mungrel with nothing easy. I'll do that, double back on the other pocket and promote some balls. I think it may be touching balls. It's unfortunately left the white in an awkward position. He's Chinese snooker. His only other option is to run the yellow that's covering the red to the middle, underneath the red on the end pocket, I guess. well done, but I think there's a bit of a gap for if Mungo gets position after potting the red ball to the top right hand pocket, there should be a gap to run the red near the yellow past it. So it looks like an out pattern from him. If Mungo gets this, he's definitely on and out. Middle right, middle left, and he's out. Just needs to work out. Oh, he probably leaves the middle left to last, actually, because that's probably the important board to transition to the black. Now that I look at the table properly. So here I play the red with a touch of top left and then hold her on. Yeah, that's worked out well.
Fine cut.
Alright, I'm back everyone.
So George is back. Mungo's on red.
I was on red, okay.
And out was definitely there, Mungo wanted to go for it, but slopped up that corner, so it's still a difficult game for me.
Mungo's got full control now.
I was saying, if you potted that, that would have been easy now.
Oh yeah, I'm sure, he probably did want to pot it.
Work out how he, if he's
scoped
it out, how
he's
gonna pass.
He can't get it out. He'd have to hit one of the reds under the yellow. The yellow would have to come out.
Here.
He could just play down there as well, which is what he's done. Now he's created the, now he can actually hit that. The yellow ball will come out. And red ball can stay there, so that's a really nice shot. Nick will play it probably safely for a snooker, which he hasn't got because it just came out.
It's such a good shot. If Mungo hits it, it has to be on the left side of the ball, so there's always a chance of running off.
Yeah, that's the other thing too, yeah. Definitely both fighting for this. It's not on the YouTube channel, by the way.
Oh, is it?
No. It's on the live stream website, like.
Okay.
So, Kylie, if you're still watching, Matt's match is on the actual live stream website, or this link that you got onto this. We have the previous matches on there.
Lining up to pop the yellow pine to the middle and knock the red out, or is he going for a snooker?
I think he has to go for a snooker here. I think he's...
spot it.
The black is blocking the natural path or be able to put a left hand side to get to those two on the bottom left.
I don't think Mungo has much of a choice, although you're now proving wrong here.
I don't know, but it's gone off 2 hours, it's a nice shot.
And he's actually hit the yellow that's in between the two reds.
There is no yellow between the two reds.
Oh, is there? Oh, where is it?
So I wasn't watching, so I actually didn't see him actually get that out. So he's played another safety shot and he has got it. But again, he's got the natural angle coming out.
Yeah, he just played the cue ball just right off the black ball. It's a natural angle to bring the cue ball back to those two yellows. Large zone chain that. Nice shot. Yeah, Shane, the venue's gone a bit quiet, which is why we're speaking a bit lower, because we're so close to the table, we always run the risk of...
there you go, Shane. I've gone a little bit closer to the mic, so it should be fine now. So Nicole just got a frame off Joe T, so 7-5 over that table. Kenny Nichols on the hill. Gets near. I think Neil must have just got a frame. Must be 8-5. That's not wrong. And Jack has called his way back and getting to 7-5 against Matt. So a good match happening over there as well.
Well, Jack looked a bit nervous at the start, but he certainly now looks to have shaken off his nerves and is playing a really free-flowing game against Matt Harmon.
So, yeah, Jack will actually want to win this because he's going over to the Worlds and may not be here when the Open Trials is on. So, this will guarantee him a spot in the state team in November.
Does Mungo have two shots, does he?
He does have two shots, so...
Ah, so that's a good promotion.
It's a bit... He's sneaking himself there.
No.
He hasn't got the angle to go off the left-hand side rail and to knock that red in. He does have the double here. If he can get this double, if he gets it in, he's got... Oh, he's going for the cut. He did... Probably a bit fine, but... So the yellow is on the bottom right.
Well,
Still has a yellow next to the black, so.
Yeah, Mick can actually slide the yellows underneath with both reds on the table looking at it.
So does Mick play that other yellow in the middle and get the same pocket?
Yeah,
that's a nice shot.
Nice shot, because he's played to control the pocket.
So Mungrel's in a bit of a pickle here. He got it out. Ooh, that black. So that's not a bad result now, because the black is blocked by that red dent now. So not easy for Mick here to promote the black from where the yellows are positioned. Could use the one on the rail to block the shot on the bottom red and promote it. The double. He's almost got it, but still, that's a shot to nothing because
That's all right.
All Mungo has now is a double, or he puts the red, and I don't think he'll foul, but if he blocks that pocket, that other yellow's so tactical all around at the moment. I'm not sure if that yellow goes in off the jaw onto the red.
Nick's probably going to go double that yellow back into traffic.
Alright, so...
should be throwing some angle here. Oh, I guess a bit premature with the black halfway like that.
No, it's not on the rail, so... just needs good position here.
So he's playing an extraction shot to hopefully bump the black
no,
out.
No, I think he'll play it. Oh, did he miss that?
Yes, he did.
He has. He didn't really want to pot that. He just tried to tap it, but he's actually missed it. So great opportunity now to Mick to get onto eight. And put the pressure right.
I actually played two of those shots last night, so I don't know if it's just the lighting, because I did that twice, where I just missed it totally.
Thanks, Shane. I just got your message saying it's all good, so... does Mick have the angle here to get the blackout? Can he get this yellow to get the blackout? If that's... you probably have to get the jigger.
Yeah, I would say just use the jigger if you have to.
Yeah, he looks like that's what he's doing.
It's going to be very tough using the jigger to control the white.
He's good with it. Whether he plays to hit off the... and he did try it, but missed it. So,
looking at the table, it looks like the black actually slides underneath the red.
So he's got, doesn't want to end up straight on this. Might be looking to get right behind the black here, or... nah, he's played a safety shot, and he has missed it. He's missed it. Alright, so... the double? No, okay. These aren't easy. And it's slightly off the cushion as well. But it's a bit, he is close to it, he's not far. You expect him to pot this. I called it. I said it's tough. It's right off the rail, but yeah, you would have expected Mick to get that, but that's it. We're going 7-all. Yeah, I'm sure he's pretty disappointed on that shot. So, this final is going to be starting pretty late.
Yeah, Jason Tanaskett's been ruled back 7-5 by Nicole.
So, Jack is on the hill against Matt.
Kenny Nichols won against Neil Whitbread, 9-5.
Okay, so Kenny's coming up against either Jack or Matt.
So Matt's got a bit of work to do. He's got to win the next four to win. Focus, mate. So it appears JT is also on the hill now against Nicole. He's currently up 8-5.
So Mungo's on reds. Definitely looks like a pot a few balls to lay one up, or he can lay one up now.
If Mungo gets the master here, this is going to be an interesting finish. Whoever wins this frame puts the pressure on their opponent.
Very important frame.
Just tried to come off the yellow. So there is a gap. If Mick can get the one in the middle and possibly get the one along the right hand side rail to block that pocket. If he's looking to take control of the table.
The most important shot coming up on the frame.
He wants to sit this over the pocket. No, he's actually went. He's gone for the pot. He's obviously confident enough to do something here, but I think he's put the white where he's wanted it. I can't see what he's going to do from here. Besides play safe, but
it's probably like fine cut this yellow, leave it over the pocket.
Is it? Yeah, okay. No, he's played safe. Wow. He's played safe, and he's actually. He's got the snooker.
His safe play has left the ball.
But again, it's. He's played, that is an awesome shot, Mungo. Well done, mate, that is a great shot. Now Mungo has complete control. All the reds are pottle, he is fouled. I think Mungo will get on the hill here.
Yeah, that snooker could be a potential match winner.
Yeah, with two visits, I can't see. You know, Mungo would have to snooker himself. You know, the black pots in the bottom left. You got only pots in the bottom left, so could be wrong.
It's hard to tell.
Oh, top right also, so he could be going for the long black. He still gets size two. Ooh.
he's still got two, is it?
Yeah, he's still got two. He's looking at the long black now. The from the top, top right, as we're looking at the table. But still has two, so looking at his all his options. So for those interested, this match has been going on for 2 hours and 20 minutes. Okay, so he hasn't come far back, and he's just confirming with Mick that he still has two visits, so he's probably just going to lay this up into the wall. He has not hit that where he's wanted. Well, he's got down pretty fast, he's pretty confident. Oh, Mick, I think he rushed that, but Mungo does play fast. He got down straight on that
still
shot.
Still leaves Mick with a tough pot. So Mick's got to make a tough pot, move the white ball in a central position where he can snooker.
Yeah,
making a pot's the most important.
I think he either needs to play the one in the middle or the one down the bottom and play for a snooker. I think that's what he's doing. I think he's trying to get rid of his one of his, promotes one of his balls and also provide a snooker. So he hasn't. So quite too much pace on that shot. So, barring a miracle, we're going to 8-7 to Mungo. He has crawled back and taken the lead.
On the hill. This match has almost gone on for 2 hours and 30 minutes.
Yeah, that's right. So,
cut, Mika, lift.
Focus, mate. You got it. Split. He has potted a yellow.
Yellows are nice, except for the one stuck near the red at the bottom right hand.
Yeah, I would prefer yellows here. I don't know if he's going to pot this, but so. What was I thinking? Why the hell wouldn't you put that? He's going for the middle. No, he's going to foul.
He's hit it too soft.
Wow,
again.
He's given
that's
two
his,
shots to Nick now.
Second two visits from hitting the ball too soft.
So, yeah, that cluster of balls on the bottom right, that's going to be where Mick needs to do something. Getting rid of his problem ball here. I think this is the right shot. Ready to come up to the table. Still has two visits. I think he wants control of this bottom right pocket. So Jack is about to shoot for the black for the win. And Jack has won the match. So Jack is up and will be playing the winner of this match, I believe. Or was it Kenny that he was playing?
No, it's Jack versus Kenny Nichol.
Sorry, yeah, okay. It's Jack versus Kenny. Piers JT has also won. So we only have one match left before the semi-finals. So Our semi-finalists so far is JT, Jack and Kenny. They will be starting shortly after this match.
And on the drive, on the way to the venue, George, we were talking about Jack, JT and Kenny as being the three favourites along with Mick Norton, weren't we?
Yeah, we were, actually. And Mungo. So...
Does Mick still have two visits?
To be honest, I took my eyes off for a moment because I was just talking to Matt Harpin, and even if he doesn't, I think he just needs to come screw back here. It's got the angle, it'll come away from the black. Bottom right, I mean, I think we are going to a decider in this match. Oh no. Whoa. That was close. So it appears we are going to a deciding frame.
And it's Mick's break.
So if he can put one on the break here and take control of the table.
Yep, anything on the break.
So just needs anything on the break and needs to take control. It all just comes down to one frame.
Something weird's happened to my internet, so I'm going to have to figure out what exactly happened.
Okay, that's a nice.
He's got one on the break. He's potted a yellow.
Which is yellow.
I'm
thinking reds.
I'm liking reds, but I like reds, but does he have one? So he has nominated reds. Nope. He's changed to yellow. Nope. So he got Kenny here next to us.
I think he's mentally preparing for his game for the semis.
So, open table. Ah, nice.
So everyone's
going it's all about the money.
So once the game, the venue's gone a little bit quiet, so I'll try and speak a bit softer so it's not to distract the players. But red's
so
looking
he's
really,
taking
really
reds.
Nice. Was a great shot. Look. Mm.
wondering if he's looking at the red next to the yellow to the middle pockets.
I think it pots.
To the bottom as well.
I think it pots in the bottom as well, so.
It's got two options.
I'm not sure. Do you play this one in the middle and then play the one on the right hand side to come up for that red to cannon?
I'm thinking he's taking the right bottom rail.
Yeah,
left rail, maybe so. Middle and then black.
If it does pass go past that yellow, then he'll be playing for the cannon. Oh, second. No, he did Mungrel win? No, sorry, second. He didn't fair. He just missed the nominated red. So you could see the flashing lights. That is a nice pop there. That is a nice pop. So Mick has a really, really good chance here to take this out.
Yes.
I think in yeah. Odd. The pot out is there.
Just I think we'll go right middle,
just need some
left
good pots,
middle,
some good queuing,
and
then
run that ball to gain control.
So he's playing this one first, trouble ball. But what is he? If he gets this, what? Oh, he's come back out. Okay, that is a really good pot. Now, hopefully, that red that he just knocked out hasn't blocked the path for the yellow to pot on the bottom.
No, it's
left,
actually
looking
at
the table.
It goes.
It does go?
Yeah, looking at the table, it goes.
Okay, well, I'd be taking one on the left.
Yeah, left, right.
Taking the one on the right in the middle, playing the one down the rail on the right-hand side, playing the one next to the red in the left-hand side, with a little follow-through for the black into the middle. Unless he's got a bit of an angle, can... screw back a little bit for the black into the same pocket, so... He just needs to focus here, make sure he pots well.
Okay.
Yeah, so it appears he's taking the path that I mentioned. It all depends on now what he wants to, how he wants to get into the black and where he leaves that white to get onto the black.
I think you just run the white through if you get that shot.
He's locked up. He missed that. He did not mean to do that. He's scratching his head because he did not mean.
Oh, so he went for the pot.
No, I think he went for the pot. He was scratching his head when he walked away. So
still not too bad. He got a result because he still controls that pocket. Now he's got shots to get that yellow out.
I could be wrong. Maybe he did mean that. Mungrel's probably going to get this out now. And he's almost potted it too.
Mungrel's just changed the layout of the table. I think the black and red are... the black and yellow are touching, so Nick will need to, I guess, play out. Promote the ball and play good safety here. That's a percentage play.
That is a nice pot. How does that yellow?
It's on middle. I think it's a fine cut line to the middle.
This isn't easy. It's
that train
is
a whole
it is not easy. But if he gets it, he's got the He did not hit it hard enough. If he hit that harder, he would have been on the black and potted it.
Well, he's got three balls to get to the semis.
Mungrel, I think Mungrel will take this. That's best opportunity now. It's actually gone really quiet in the club at the moment, so the tension's all there at the moment. And has he? This is going to be interesting.
Super going to cut this to the middle, past the yellow, or take a long pop.
Nah, you can't play in the middle. Surely he needs to go long. You know, I guess going in the middle, it's a little bit larger because the yellow's there, but. It's going to be very interesting here. He's potted it. That is a beautiful. So, one long pot now for the win. Place into the semi-finals. He's got it. Beautiful shot.
Good for Mick. Unlucky to Mick. He undercut that yellow to the middle.
Yeah.
A bit harder. He would have had a perfect shot on the black.
All right. We're just going to wait for the semi-final matchup and call. We might see if Matt's interest. We'll also see if Matt Harmon's interest to commentate when he finishes doing his tournament director duty.